Hello all, in this video I'll discuss about different kind of keys in DBMS, a database management system. See, number of times we heard about different terms, different kind of keys in DBMS. So let's see what is key. So a key is an attribute or a set of attributes which identify a row or tuple in a relation or table. Now, if you look at this example, this is student table. Roll number is a key because it can identify a tuple, a row, or a student uniquely. Citizenship ID is a key. Email ID is another key. Okay, so all of them are different keys for this table. Next comes composite key. So what is composite key? If multiple attributes together creates a key, or a set of attributes creates a key, we call it composite key. So in composite key, each column may not be unique by itself. Like say date of birth and name together, we may use to identify one student in a student database table. But that is going to be a composite key, right? Because we are using two attributes together. Now you can say that two person can have same date of birth. Yeah, that is there. So one part of or one attribute may not have unique value in all the fields. So this is what composite key. Next comes super key. A super key is a set of attribute which may have some extra or additional attribute that are actually not needed for uniquely identify a tuple. Like if I say the email ID, date of birth, and name and department together a key. Yeah, my argument, yes, it is a key. But if you think about a better key, or what are the necessary things in the key, necessary attributes, you can say that department is quite irrelevant to be in the key or as a part of a key, right? So this is what is super key. So here you can see that super key may be composite key or any other kind of key. Next is candidate key. So I like to call it candidate for primary key. So minimal super key, or if we reduce the super key, that means reduce to the minimal size, minimum number of attributes which can identify a tuple in the table uniquely, that is going to be treated as candidate key. So here in this table we can see roll number is a candidate key, citizenship ID is a candidate key, email ID is a candidate key, date of birth and email name together can be treated as a candidate key. Next come primary key. So primary key is nothing but a designation. We have too many candidate key. We choose one suitable one for use as primary key, or designating it as primary key for a table. It has some property, so when we are choosing, we must see that primary key is satisfying all these properties. These properties are, it must be unique for each tuple, it must not be null in any case, and it should be a small measurable size which will be handy to handle by the database users. So in this table you can use roll number as primary key, and we usually underline the primary key. So that is just has been done here. Next comes alternate key. So if you see in the diagram, the candidate key, out of this candidate key, one is the primary key, and what about the remaining others? So there is four candidate key, and primary key become the one of them. Okay, so remaining three will be called as alternate key. Now for this table, if roll number is the primary key, then citizenship ID and email becomes alternate key. okay? Artificial key or surrogate key? So if we don't have any key which is suitable enough for our use as primary key, then we add extra, database administrator created attribute which will be treated as primary key. So here roll number, if you see, think about the roll number of a student, it is given by the authority or the university or the school, right? It is not inbuilt attribute comes with the student, right? When a student comes, he is a person. How he can come with a roll number? So roll number is assigned to him only because he can be identified by roll number in the university uniquely. So this is one kind of key we call as artificial key or surrogate key. Next is foreign key. If you see the student table, student have a department. So instead of having only department name, we can simply connect the student to its department by using department ID. And department ID is primary key of department table, where all other detail of the department is there. So if primary key of one table is going to be used as attribute of another table, then that will be called as foreign key. Compound key. So compound key usually it looks like composite key, but usually one or more attribute in compound key are foreign key. Like here, if you look at this relation, student opts for courses and opts, this relation is having a attribute grade. So how to identify this grade uniquely, identify grade of student uniquely in a particular course? So that time we will need roll number, course code, what is the corresponding grade. So here this is composite key for this table, roll number and course code together, and both of them are foreign key from some other table. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, like, share and comment.